effect of free and widely available pornography is having on young people, especially men, in our society at this time?
Well, I think it's like Treasure Island in Pinocchio. It's all pleasure with no responsibility. That's deadening. It's parasitical in a sense. And I don't mean that, I'm not making a value judgment. I mean, it's no wonder the young guys are caught up in this because it's an unbelievably powerful technology. It drove the development of the internet, let's not forget, yeah. Right? So it taps into one viciously primordial motivation. And so these guys are being blasted by what biologists call super stimuli all the time. So imagine that there's a biological stimulus that has an effect on you, and then you can magnify it. And the typical porn actress, not the amateurs, but the professionals, have their sexually provocative physical elements exaggerated. Mm-hmm. And so men are very visual in terms of their sexual processing. The guys are pulled into it, and they're pulled into it also by curiosity. But I think that ethically, it's not good. It's not good. It's an easy out. That's the other thing, you know, yeah. What you should be doing is going and finding someone to have a relationship with. And if you can gratify yourself with no transformation, but let's say you can't find someone, well, then you might say that's an indication you should change. Mm-hmm. It is, in fact, an indication that you should change, because what better indication are you going to get than that no one wants to be intimate right. with you?
Right.
It's the ultimate rejection, and that's partly why men are terrified of it, and I understand that. And I also understand the MGTOW guys, you know, who are just recommending that men don't enter into long-term permanent relationships with women. I understand where they're coming from, although I called them pathetic weasels a while back. I shouldn't have done that.
See, that's where I said, are you worried about every
yeah,
little
yeah,
thing?
Yeah.
So once you say some...
Well, they're providing a lot of young guys who need a kick to go out there.
Right, they're actually giving them the back door.
They're giving them a rationale, yeah. And I've seen this have very detrimental effects on a number of people already. And partly in my clinical practice, because these guys, the young guys who aren't successful, they're looking for a reason why women are terrible, because otherwise they have to think, well, they're just not presentable, which is what they do have to think, because that's almost the definition of presentable, right? So, and then the MGTOW guys give them a rationale, you know, we are in a gynocentric world and females have got control and they'll like wipe you out if they have the opportunity. It's like, well, some females will do that to some guys some of the time, and sometimes it's brutal. I've had clients who've been dragged through the court systems and mm-hmm. just ruined, and I was unable to help them. I did everything I could to maneuver and negotiate and plan and strategize so carefully to get them to do everything right, and it didn't help. Mm-hmm. I mean, the court systems can be absolutely brutal to men. It's awful.
Yeah, that's really interesting.
What advice would you give to someone looking to quit porn? Well, I gave some advice a little earlier about quitting alcohol, you know, and I would say it isn't that you're trying to quit porn. It's not the right way to think about it. The right way to think about it is that you're trying to figure out how to have a better life. And so you have to figure out, well, I would say do the future authoring program and keep your porn addiction in mind and think. So in the first part of the future authoring program, it asks you a bunch of questions about what your life could be like in 3 to 5 years if you took care of yourself like you were someone that you cared for. And then it asks you questions about your friends and your family and your career and your time outside of work and your health and, you know, the important dimensions of life. And it asks you to spend 20 minutes writing about how good your life could be in 3 to 5 years if you got your act together and did what was good for you. And then it asks you to write about the hell you could be in if you didn't. And so I would say you really need to do that, because porn isn't the issue. The issue is that you're not living your life the way you want to. And so you need a vision of life that's more compelling than the porn. And you need a counter vision too that frightens you, you know, because otherwise porn is obviously extraordinarily gratifying in the short term, but you seem to be suffering from the medium to long term consequences of its use. And so you need a story that you can tell yourself that's really deeply thought through about why this is not appropriate for you, how it's hurting you, and how it's minimizing you, and perhaps making you embarrassed and ashamed and more socially isolated, and all of that. So I would say, think about it as cleaning up your psyche and your behavior, rather than merely stopping stopping porn. You also might want to write down, and you could do this in the negative vision part of the future authoring program, you got to write down everything bad that you think porn is doing to you, because obviously you have some suspicions that this is not good for you, right? That it's actually harming you in some important way. And so you need to be fully cognizant of what those ways are and then take them seriously and decide if that's the pathway through life on which you wish to travel. And so, and then I would also say good luck to you. You know, it's a very good idea to identify one of your weaknesses and work on it. You can strengthen yourself substantially by